I don't have the best impression of snails. And not too long ago, a whole bunch of them were eating all the vegetables in my garden. And, you know, it was an open season on every snail and slug in the garden until I discovered copper tape, which reacts with their slime and it gives them a nasty sting and, you know, no more snails. Why are we talking about snails? Oh, yeah. So they're definitely not the brightest or the fastest creatures, but I was very curious then why this was called the Wonder Snail. So is this one a tale of slow and steady wins the race, or is this a nasty sting to the backside? That's what we're gonna find out today. Welcome to Machines and More. So this is a fan that a lot of you have been asking about, and today we're gonna check it out. So big thanks to Scythe for letting me review these. I did receive these fans free of charge to make this video, but this video isn't sponsored. I'm not paid for this, and the review and testing methodology is 100% my own. So many of you are familiar with the Kazi Flex, which this is a good general purpose fan, but these do tend to top out at lower RPMs depending on the model. Like these go up to like 1500. But with kind of the same frame design and color scheme is the Scythe Wonder Snail, 120 millimeters. And unlike all the snails that I am familiar with, this is a pretty fast bugger and spec'd at 2400 RPM, plus or minus 10%. This one did test in at 2300 RPM, but I'd say that's certainly within the plus or minus 10% spec. Fluid dynamic bearing, the axle doesn't have play in it, but the blades are a little bit flexy, just like the Kaze Flex. Not high-end quality, but not exactly cheap junk either. So kind of just in the middle. 9 blades, and it does spin clockwise, as opposed to counterclockwise for a lot of fans. And I do think I understand where it gets its name from, because it's got this curvature, kind of like the whirl of a snail, but without the slime. So you have a moderate budget, and you're looking for a good performance fan, you might be interested in this one since it comes in at only $17 US. To test it out, I stuck it on the open air test system that's running a 10850K with a 360 rad. Let's see how it does. Many of you have seen the Phanteks T30 review, and while these are in a different price tier, it's still a good reference point. I will be comparing these against the higher end fans today as a reference point, but I will just include this one into the 120 millimeter rad fans part 2 that's coming out. So with that, let's jump into some noise normalized testing. At a lower noise level, the Wonder Snail spins at 1100 RPM versus the Nocto NFA 12x25 at 1200 and T30 at 1250. And I'm actually surprised how close it came to the Noctua. The coolant temp ends up about a degree and a half behind, and the CPU package temp follows a similar gap. That's not too bad when you consider that the Noctua is almost twice as expensive. Now, I did get a bit of an odd noise pattern at this noise level, but I'll get into that next when it comes to acoustics. At the next level of plus 1.6 decibels from the noise floor, we're still about the same. About a 2 degree gap in the coolant, about the same for the CPU temps, and this is about 67% PWM for the Wonder Snails. Last in our noise normalized comparisons is the plus 5.4 decibel noise level. And yes, between 1450 and 1775 RPM, there's a big jump in the noise level for this fan. But even with the RPM deficit against the other two, the Wonder Snail isn't terribly far behind. I mean, it's a significant gap, but it's still within 1.5 to 2 degrees overall of the Noctua. So noise normalized RPMs are a little bit slower, but I wouldn't quite call this one a snail's pace, but that is responsible in part for the thermal gap there. I mean, if you look at the results between the three levels, basically the Wonder Snail's performance from the two higher noise levels is close to the Noctua's performance at the sound level before it. Speaking of sound, these fans aren't bad, but I did detect some hum, especially at 1100 RPM. I'll be moving the mic a little bit closer to highlight it at 1100 RPM. Then I'll take you through the other noise levels. The noise characteristics aren't the most polished, but then again, I'm testing on an open-air rad system. If you have it inside the case, you might not hear it that well. We're talking about a fan that meets a moderate budget after all. But overall, it is a decent fan if you can stay out of the RPMs that have the odd noise. And while the build quality does lag behind that of the higher priced competitors, I say it's pretty close to that from the Arctic P12s. And actually, they look a lot like the P12 Slims, right? But these also have that same feedback at around the same RPMs, like 1100 RPM, you got that P12 growl, kind of the same here. A little food for thought, for the price of three of these, you can only get 1.7 T30s. So what happens when we price normalize? Well, let's cut the T30 a little slack and we'll round up to two. So what happens when we compare three snails against two T30s at full speed? Well, the T30s go up to 3000 RPM. And at that level, two of these are 5 decibels louder compared to the three Scythe fans at 2300 RPM. It's close, but it's still pretty interesting. The T30 still comes out slightly ahead. Of course, I doubt anyone will really want to run fans at this noise level. I mean, this is 12 to 17 decibels over the noise floor. So realistically speaking, at reasonable noise levels, three of these Wonder Snails will match or slightly exceed the performance from two T30s. So if you're space constrained and you can only fit a 240, it's actually pretty interesting how far you can go with two T30s, but a lot of you are budget constrained and you have space. So in that case, it makes a lot of sense to go with more fans at a lower speed on a bigger rad. And I'm pretty impressed how close these come to the higher priced competitors. And this were a snail, it's the fastest snail in town. So we'll see how it stacks up against some similar priced fans in a video coming up later this year. Stay tuned for that. And the Inner 200P Max review should be coming up next. Let me know if you have any questions about that case, because I will be going through some of the comments and answering those questions in the initial review. So make sure you're subscribed, hit that bell for notifications, give a like, links down below for these. Thanks for watching today.